Hello friends, in this video we will see the programs using arrays. So in the first array, we will see how to initialize an array. We can initialize an array like this. A of 10 is equal to, we can give 10 values separated by commas in a flower braces, in the curly braces. So this way we can initialize an array. If we say without the index, without this array size here, you can see I am not defining the array size here, but if I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values, so it will assume as x of 5. So this is valid. So whenever you use like this m of 3 and try to give more than 3 values, it will give you an error. We'll see, I'll uncomment this. We'll say alt F9. You can see we get one error. There's too many initializers in function main. So we cannot give more than 3 values here. So this is incorrect. I'll comment this, or I'll delete this. Okay. To initialize an array, we can use either this form or this form. They are perfectly legal. So to print the values of an array, I am using a for loop. For I is equal to 0, I am using I as loop variable. So I less than 10, 0 less than 10 is true. So here I am printing a statement, a square bracket percentage d square bracket is equal to percentage d. So in the place of first percentage d, I want to print the value of I. If initially I is 0, it should print a of 0. So in the a of 0, what is the value is there? So if I have to print the value, I have to say a of I. So it will print the value at a of I. So this will print the I value, this will print the value at I, a of I. So I'm just giving two escape characters after this. So and I'm printing the second float array here. This array I'm saying I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So what happens is when I is equal to 0, a of 0, x of 0 prints x of 0. Here it comes as 0 and here it prints x of 0 value. So this is the value we are going to print, x of 0. Then I increments to 1. So 1 less than 5 is true. So x of 1 prints, and here it prints as x square bracket 1 because we are printing I value here. And it prints x of I value, the content of x of I. So then again x increments, I increments to 2, 2 less than 5. So it prints x of 2 here in the place of percentage f. So I increments to 3, then it prints x of 3, and I increments to 4, it prints x of 4, and I increments to 5, it fails this condition. 4 less than 5 is true, false. It's 4 less than 5 is false, and this statement fails and comes out of the loop. We'll see the execution of this program. I'll say alt F9. I'll compile the program. Whenever I click Alt F9, it compiles the program. I'll click Control F9. So it's executing the program. You can see I'm entering values 11, 22, 33 in array A of 0 from the program. So when we output the A of array A, you can see here it prints 0, 1, 2, 3 because we have, you can see here I printed in the place of percentage D, I'm printing I. So it comes in the format A of 0 is equal to 11 here. So here it prints the I value, it prints A square bracket 0 here because we are telling that first percentage D is I, and is equal to second percentage D is the value at the location I. If I is equal to 0, it will print value at A of 0, if I is equal to 0. If I is equal to 1, here it will be print, here it will print the value A of 1 value. So this way, we get the output. Then again, I'm using slash n 2 times, so that I get some separation between two for loops, two outputs. So again, we are trying to print the float array. So you can see, I have entered 10, 20, 30, 40, but it will be saved as 10.000000 in the memory. So this way, we can initialize an array and output array values. So we'll see one more example. So here, I have used for loop to initialize the array and for loop to print the array. So here I have declared a variable I of type int and an array of 10 size. That's also of type int. You can also define if you want float. So if you want to print character array, so that will be a different, we'll see in a different video about character arrays. So I'll say enter 10 values to the user. So user starts entering values. So we use a for loop to enter each to take input each value. I'm using I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus. So when first time scan executes, I will be 0. So A of 0, the value will be taken from the keyboard. Next, I increments to 1. So again, scanf executes. So this time the input will be taken for A of 1. Again, I increments to 2, and again scanf executes, the value will be taken for A of 2. This way we can take input value for each memory location using I as loop variable and index variable. Again, to print out the same, we can use A of I, print A of I for every value of I. When I is 0, it prints value at A of 0. When I is 1, it prints value at A of 1. When I's value is 10, it will print the value at A of 10. So this way we can use a for loop to initialize an array. I'll say Alt F9. I'll do Control F9 again to run the program. So now I can say, it says enter 10 value. I'll say 1 space 2, 2 space 3. So I'll enter this value. You can see it prints the value like this. So it's just taking, using a for loop to take input from here and using a for loop to print the values here like this. So it's a simple program which takes input values from using a for loop and outputs the value using for loop. We'll see that example. So in this example, we want to add sum of 10 elements. So the 10 elements will be in the array. Say this is similar to the previous program till here. So we just say enter 10 values, and the 10 values will be taken into the array from A of 0 to A of 9. So, and again we say, for every time we'll initially sum is equal to 0. So we'll add all the values to sum, and finally we'll give sum. For first time when I is equal to 0, A of 0 will be added to sum. Sum is also 0, and this whatever the value enter for A of 0 will be added to sum. Next I becomes 1, and next A of 1 will be added to sum. Next I becomes 2, A of 2 will be added to sum and given and is saved in sum. Again, when I is equal to 3, A of 3 will be added to sum and will be saved in the total, will be saved in sum again. So after the loop completes, this loop completes, the total sum will be calculated for all the zero values from 0 to 9, A of 0 to A of 9. So that we can print out using a single for loop, because we are not printing more than one value. Sum is a single value. So we can use without a loop here, print f, the sum of total, the sum total is equal to percentage d comma sum. So in the place of percentage d, sum will be printed. So I'll do Alt F9 and I'll do Control F9. So it says enter 10 value. I'll say 4 plus 5 plus 3 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus, okay, 5's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have entered 7 values. I'll enter 3 more values and press enter. You can see it gives total sum of all the numbers. So this way we can do sum of 10 numbers or n numbers depending upon the index. So we'll see one more example. This is a linear search example. In this example, we'll have an array of 10 values. You can have more than 10. I'm just giving a simple example. And we'll find a key element in that. If we enter 10 values, we'll check whether the given key element will be present in the array or not. So this, here we are initializing, we are declaring a variable I, a of 10 and array, and a variable key of type int. So we say enter 10 value, the user enters 10 values, so it will be taken input using this for loop. For a of 0, a of 1 till a of 9, the value will be taken. And then we say enter a number to search. So the user enters a number to search. And in that row, the whatever the value entered for key will be searched. You can see in the for loop, I'm using same for loop from 0 to 9. You can see I less than 10. And I'm checking for every value. If a of 0 is equal to, a of 0 is the value inside the array, inside the location a of 0. So we'll check for a of 0 is equal to the key. If it's key, it says key found. After it will print, if it's not true, if the a of 0 is not equal to key, it again goes to the loop and increments I, and if next a of I will be checked with the key. If a of I contains the key value entered in the key, so then it will be true and the printf statement executes and it comes to exit 0. Exit 0 is a function used from standard lib. You can see here, I'm using a library called standard lib. So we can use standard lib exit 0 function from the standard lib to come out of the program. So if the key is found, so it exits out of the loop and program, complete program, it exits out of the program. If the key is not found, so this if body will never get executed, and after the completion of the loop, this statement will be executed, says key not found. So if key is not found anywhere in the loop, so it says key not found. So we'll see this program, we'll compile this, we'll do Alt F9 and we'll do Control F9. I'll say 22, 33, 44, 55, 66, 77, 88, 88, 99. So I entered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 values I've entered. So I will say 66. I want to look for 66 and press enter. It says key found. Now I'll do Alt F9. I'll do Control F9. I'll say 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 21. So we entered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 values, and I'll say 22. So it says key not found. So this way we can use a linear search to find an element. So say we can use exit 0 function and exit out of the program whenever the key is found. And whenever the key is not found, so this block will not be executed. And that's directly this will, after the completion of for loop, it gets executed. So you can use exit function to exit out of the program from anywhere in the program. Any point of time you use the exit 0, you must have a standard lib directory included, standard lib header file included. So then you can use exit function. So whenever you say exit 0, it comes out of the program. The program will be halted. So we'll see one more, same linear search program with a different approach. We'll not use exit function this time. So this time I'm using the same variables, everything. I'm taking values from the keyboard using scanf and for loop. And I'm saying the user to enter a key number, a number to search, and we are taking that value inside key. So this time I'm using a variable called found. So I declared here found is equal to 0. So if whenever the key is found, so the found value become 1, else it will remain as 0. You can see if the key is not found in the for loop anywhere for a of 0, because I is 0 initially in the loop, then I increments to 1. I of 1 is checked for the key, I of 2 is checked with the key, I of 3 is checked with the key, till I of 0 to I of 9 will be checked with the key. So if the key is not found, so the else will be executed every time and found remains 0. If first time A of 0 is equal to key, if it's not true, so the found is equal to 0 will be executed again. So whenever this becomes true, found is equal, found becomes 1. So then after this loop, we can see if the found is equal to 1, then print key found, else say print key not found. This way we can avoid using exit 0 if you don't want to halt the program there and you want the loop to execute completely. So once the key is found, so what you can do is, if the key is found, you can say break here. So it will break out of the loop. You don't have to search. Once the key is found, you don't have to search again and again. You can say key found. So you have to say break, otherwise the next time, once the key is found, the found becomes 1. And after that, if the key is not found, it becomes 0. So the break is very important. I'll do Alt F9, Control F9. So this time we'll say 11, 22, 33, 44, 55, 66, 77, 88, 99, 10, 10. Okay. It says enter the number to search. I'll say 55. Key found. So this way we can search the key using for loop and without using the exit statement or the exit function. Friends, in this video we have learnt about functions, how to do programs using arrays. So in the upcoming video we'll see more about we'll see two more programs in arrays, that's binary search and bubble sort. So later we can move to the character arrays. So thank you for watching this video.